Let's take a look at the million-dollar question of how long does it take concrete to dry, and some possible ways of helping expedite the process. The biggest question I hear all the time is, how long is it really going to take my concrete to dry? So I take a step back a little bit and I try to really distinguish between two terms that seem to be used synonymously out there and that cause a lot of confusion for people. There's the term of curing and the term of drying. They're used a lot of times interchangeably. Curing is when somebody comes up to you and they say, how can my concrete be that wet in relationship to installing the flooring, but I've been walking on it for the last 60 days, 90 days, things along those lines. Well, concrete will cure or get hard, even if it's underneath water. But in relationship to installing flooring, it needs to dry out after it's gotten hard. And so when you look at a rule of thumb that the Portland Cement Association actually has on their website, it states that once you have conditions that are conducive for the concrete to dry, meaning that you have consistent, reasonable heat in the air and low relative humidity, so the building needs to be enclosed. Usually the easiest way is HVAC up and running. You're typically looking at, it's going to take 30 days for every 1 inch of slab thickness for the concrete to dry to a reasonable level of between 85 and 90% relative humidity. Now, I say it like that because you can have concrete down for a year, but it hasn't been enclosed until the last 30 days. And when you look at that, it really hasn't started drying until those last 30 days. The other time, it could have had weather on it, could have had water on it, things along those lines. Now, a lot of people will say that to try to help expedite, there's numerous processes, but one is if you have the ability to help with the specifications of the finish on the concrete, sometimes that hard trowel finish gets to a point of diminishing return and it actually burnishes the surface of the concrete. And a lot of people think that that really does burnish the surface and hurt the ability of the moisture to evaporate out of the concrete. So if you can do a lightly trowel finish. The other thing is, obviously, get the building enclosed as quickly as possible. The ambient conditions as consistent as possible. Usually it's going to require some heat. It's going to require some air blowing across the concrete. And then usually some kind of dehumidification to pull that moisture out of the air. So if you're trying to expedite, the heat will allow the moisture to rise out of the concrete. The wind, once the moisture gets to the surface, the air across the surface of the concrete will pick it up quicker. And then the dehumidifiers will actually help to pull that out of the air, and that whole cycle can continue. But you have to make sure that you keep all those things working synonymously with each other, because if you don't, one part breaks down, you will start taking steps backwards. Hit me up on Twitter at RapidRHRep and let me know if any of these points helped you out.